Britain, in America, it counts every February. The reason why it counts in February is because the man who actually started Black History Month, Dr. Weston, chose that particular month because they had two birthdays in February. One was for a Black American activist, and the other one was for the American president. So it was for President Abraham Lincoln, who was born in February, and the other one was for Mr. Douglas Scott, Scott Douglas. So these gentlemen, one black, one white, were really active in trying to make sure that Black American history would improve over the centuries. And lo and behold, we've had a Black American president. However, as far as I'm aware, he's not the first Black American president. He's actually supposed to be the second Black American president. Most people are unaware that there was a previous Black American president, but because of the situation and politics and social race relations, he didn't go around advertising, "Hey guys, I'm black too, okay?" He never did it, like Chris Gilbert. But that's a different story. Now, Black History Month is supposed to engender feelings of worthiness, of ability to say, look, all the nations of the world can actually do things, including black people. And black people live in the diaspora, some in Britain, some in North America, some in South America, parts of Asia, you name it, just like every other national group in the world, which is brilliant. Okay? Right, okay, if we just go quickly. Now, one of the things you do find is that black people are underrepresented in science. Science for many years has become seen as one of the most dominant areas in which people participate in. So, quite correctly, a lot of white people are involved in science. People like, say, Isaac Newton, who happened to be a Christian as well. Roger Bacon, fantastic Christian, developers of science. But today, it appears as if science is seen as a shrine to the god science. So people worship, like Baal worship, at science, but they forget God. Behind, he's a guy who just started this stuff. Moving on. Carry on.
Thank you.
As I said, those are the two birthdays of this gentleman. That's the reason why in America Black History Month is in February. Okay. Moving on. And that is the sub-stereotype, is like you just saw that horrible mask of things, which unfortunately still occurs even today in 2016, right? Because people forget that God created everybody. That's what makes us valuable. Because God has put his image in you. You're all made in the image of God. So skin is simply the appearance on the outside. What's in the heart is the most important thing. And you see, you're a spirit and a body with a soul. So those stereotypes, unfortunately, still carry on even today, which is to a shame of everyone. Moving on. This is what I meant. At the university, just recently, right, they put up Asians as representatives of Black History Month. So the university is going, what happened? This is weird. Okay? And this is 2016, just 2 weeks ago, in England. So there's a big ruckus about it. I said, why don't you get some black heroes or black heroines? Did you have to go to Asia? Okay, these guys are not your good. But it, you know, one is the mayor, one that's sneaky. But why are you going to put in the Black History Month, for goodness sakes? Doesn't make sense. So the stereotypes that we try to address in Black History Month are still around, unfortunately. Next. Moving on. Right, United Kingdom. People who are black or African origin have been living in Britain for centuries, not just the last 200 years. Okay? And it's very important to grasp this because you see, we sometimes get sidetracked by thinking wrongly that black people have only been here for the last 500 years. Actually, pockets of black people have been living in Britain, living in Russia, living in Scandinavia for centuries. Okay? Just one quick example, right? Moving on. Right, there we go. This was actually discovered. A woman who was a representative of an African lady from so-called sub-Saharan Africa. I hate the word Sahara, by the way. I call it the Great African Desert. Because the word Sahara is Arabic. It's not an African word. It's a big desert. So they found the remnants of an African woman from places like maybe the Congo, Tanzania, Zambia, whatever. But she was actually in England in the 1500s and before. So they were shocked. Moving on. And this is a lady, another lady. They found the bones and they reconstructed them and said, this is what she looked like. And this lady was found, again, a long time ago, but she was living in the southern of England. Now, I think it's about 200 AD. Right, moving on. And today, there was a discovery that some people from West Africa, especially the Niger, share a lineage with people in the Basque region of Spain. They share the same language words. Alright, so people are surprised. Well, I'm not. But this is God's world, and people travel the world. Okay, moving on. Okay, let's move on a bit. That's Scotland. Okay, in Scotland, the same phenomenon. You find black Scots living in Scotland centuries ago before the Romans were there. Okay, so this is a good example. For example, let's move on. Thank you. Yep. That's one. That's the lady who died 1025 AD, quite a long time, over a century bit. Okay, they found the remains, an African woman. She's dressed like a lovely lady in front, right? Okay. Moving on. Okay, these are records. So we have historical records of black Scottish people living in Scotland. Okay. It's even in the Scottish Parliament, so sorry, Royal House. Moving on. And one of them was actually a knight. Okay. So, but you don't see that in your films, do you? You don't see that in books until you start digging. Okay? Moving on. So that is the only one human race. Okay? Let's move on. Now, this guy, you know, this guy is Morgan Freeman. He's a famous black American actor, director. He's come out and said, you know what? It's good on Black History Month, but why should we just have Black History Month? History is for everybody. So he's criticized at that point and says, you know what? History is for everyone, not just one so-called race, which is true. But unfortunately, when you study this stuff in university, college, or TV, they only present usually one side, and they neglect African or Black history. So that's why the reasons for Black History Month. But I can see what he's saying.
Right, let's skip this. Let's carry on.
Okay, we know that guy is Charles Darwin. Mr. Darwin is a guy who invented what we call the modern world evolution. I call it evolution. Evil. Okay, that is a caricature saying, okay, Darwin is a white English guy, and he thought that black people are at the bottom of the evolution. That everybody came out, that your great-great-grandfather was a fish. He came out of a fish, and then moved to the earth, and became a monkey or orangutan, and then the monkey became a human being, and here we are today in 2016. So when you eat fish, you're actually eating your great ancestors. It's a weird story, isn't it? But it's not scientific. It's not science in it. But people believe in it. And if you're a Christian, you stand up and you say, this is wrong, they will what? Criticize you. And yet it's a fairy tale. But it's got damaging influences on white and black people in the world. God said, you were made in the image of God. Not in the image of a frog, or a mackerel fish, or a sardine. No. Okay? And that is crucial, because that's where you get your human rights from. That's where you get your freedom from. Recognizing that God is your creator. And not that the great-great-granddad gorilla monkey is your father or mother. Okay? So that story, unfortunately, is still around today. Let's move on quickly. Now, there have been a lot of black scientists who've actually worked in science for the glory of God. We'll look at one of them, for example. Number one. Do you know who this guy is? Everybody should know who this guy is. He came from a dirt poor family. His father and mother were slaves. He was a baby slave. But then God used him. And God showed him things that you are imagining. Tara, there's a bag there. Peanuts.
Right, peanuts. Right? What can you do with a bag of peanuts? Apart from eating them, you can get oil, you can get dyes, color, paints. That's right. Dr. Palmer, this gentleman that came out of a slave family, right? He asked God one question. Says, Lord, show me the secret of the universe. And God says, Palmer, I'm not going to show you the secret of the universe. I'm going to show you the secret of this little thing, peanuts. And that's why Dr. Carver had 100 patents all about what you can get out of peanuts. Over 100 things you can make out of a peanut. Oils, dyes, so many other things. All because he dared to ask God, show me the secret, Lord. And God said, okay, I'll show you the secret. And this food actually changed American farming. White farmers, black farmers were going out of business, were suddenly able to produce peanuts on their land and make oil, dye, paints, and make more money. That's how he saved American farming. And that's only one person. So God can use you. Next, quickly. Right, I'm running out of time because, but however, the point is, we see he's even immortalized on postage stamps in America because, wow, we did a wonderful thing. And you can do the same thing if you ask God. Prayer works, and the penis is a good example. Now, here's another one. Right, when your phones are ringing, what happens? Oh, it's nuisance, oh, whatever. The mics are operating. Right, the person who invented microphone processing things, he changed that to sound with a black American scientist, Dr. West. He's still alive today. So these things that we're using, and your mobile phones that ring, right? He's the one who invented that. And you can go ask him, how did you do this? God showed me.
That is it. That's the thing. Right? Let's just carry on quickly.
The birds can teach you. The animals can teach you. Why? God says in the book of Job. Because God says the whole of creation, God has put secrets out there that men and women, black and white, can actually use to glorify God in their work. That's why we're on an airplane. Because the Wilbur brothers were Methodists, white Christians, said, hey, birds fly. Can we do something that man can fly? And they invented the airplane. And I bet many of you have used an airplane. Come. Yeah? But these were Christians. They're better than the airplane. Because they said, God can teach us how the birds fly. We can copy. And now today you take it from God. Right?
There we go. Let's move on quickly. I'll close, but then I'll try to try it. Right. This guy was a man who started looking at insects, a black American doctor. He was the first man. And he found that insects can talk, can speak. Bees can communicate. And today, if you go to universities, they use his research work, which he started over 100 years ago. Okay? Moving on quickly. Carry on. Carry on. Carry on. Those are the Wilbur brothers. That's what they look like. White brethren Christians who started the airplane. Yes, carry on. These are astronauts. That's a lady. Another astronaut. Okay. They've served under President Dr. Mary Maynard Daly, very famous woman. I don't know if she's a Christian or not. Another black American scientist. She was working in the early 1920s. It was more difficult to become a black woman and become educated and to have a doctorate at the end of the day. And yet she pioneered her way through. And she invented something which we still use today. She noticed that things about the heart. So when you go to a hospital, you're probably using some of her research. There she is. She retired. Now, just one last thing, you guys. Let's carry on. Okay, this lady. Just back a bit. Right, this lady is one amazing. What she has done is to improve eyesight for people. That's right. She invented a machine that allows her to remove cataracts from the eyes so that you can have better vision. Because she found that there were too many black people having an extra statistic of bad eyesight as compared to other national groups. But nonetheless, her work applies to equally white and black people losing eyesight. So today, when you're older and your eyesight is disappearing, unfortunately, when you get old, her work comes in and saves your eyesight. Can you imagine that? The Lord Jesus opened up the eyes of the blind. She's equally done the same thing using science and technology for the benefit of everybody. Wonderful work. And that's patented work as well. She's still alive as far as I'm aware. Let's round up. Let's go. The word H-O-P-E, help our people to emerge. Hope. That's what we need, everybody. Right? So we can, when we see these people at work, we should be empowered to say, what else can I do? Can I be like a Dr. Carver and a female? Can I be an astronaut like Dr. May or a female? Yeah, she's done it. Well, I could do the same thing. Why shouldn't people stop from studying physics, chemistry, biology, not just history, economics, but anything to glorify God in what I do? Whether you're black or white. But obviously, because it's Black History Month, what can you black as a person do to benefit the whole world? Like as I said, God for a day and everybody else.
So we give God the glory for all these amazing people. Some still alive today. Most people don't know about, but thankfully we can. And use them as our example.